Now, this is a place that your family was very close. That's Walchand Terrace. So it was, in fact, it belonged to your family. But before we come to that, just so that we get a sense of how it all happened, how did you, Vinod, how did you all get involved in the theatre? What was the genesis of that particular involvement?
Well, you see, what happened was, let me go back to the beginning. In the sense, we had once gone to a play, a Hindi play, I think it was Yayati. And when we went to that play, we met, after the play, Jaswanti Tehliani. I don't know if you know her. Her husband was Admiral Tehliani. And she is the mother of the Tarun Tehliani, the one who does all this fashion designing. So anyway, Jaswanti, Vinod and I knew earlier from her friendship with Vinod's friend's sister. So we'd known her for many years, and she had also come to the play. And she said, now all after the play, all these people are coming to my house. So why don't you all come with us? So Vinod and I agreed. We had no real idea of what we wanted to. I mean, we were free. We decided, okay, chalo, chale. So we went to her place on, you know, in line with the Taj at Apollo Bandar. They had a flat. And so we all went there. And there Amrish Puri had come, Rekha was there. Then there were others from theatre unit, all the play people in the cast. They were all there. And then we heard them, you know, the usual post-play party, drinking, talking, shouting, reciting poems. And so we all were there gathered, and that is when Vinod and Satyadev had started chatting. And when they started chatting, Vinod expressed his interest in theatre, and then Satyadev said, you know, I can't really tell you what problems we are having. We have no place to rehearse. We go here, we go there. But you know, theatre really needs some space to rehearse. This was the beginning of that idea. And later on, we met through Shashank, Vinod's brother, who was doing some things for Vijaya. Mm-hmm. And I knew Vijaya from my school days. And we had also gone to see her play The Chairs, you know. There we met Arvind Deshpande, and he also must have expressed the same sentiments that there's no place for experimental theatre. We have no place to rehearse. So over, I think, a period of months, Vinod began to, as we mixed with these people and chatted with them and got to know them, they all started coming to our house quite a lot. Every Sunday, all of them would descend at our house. And we got very closely involved, you know. So then Vinod said, decided that let me see if I can do something. Now, as it happened, Vinod had an office in Walchand Terrace. And then they had again moved to construction house because some repairs were going on or something. For some reason, temporarily they were there, but they again moved to construction house. And when they moved to construction house, that place was empty. So he said to Satyadev that I will give this place to you, but I cannot promise it to you for a long time. You can use it till such time as we require it. Now, whether he also promised Arvind Deshpande that, I don't know. But Satyadev went there and he moved in, you know. He moved in, he started staying there, and then gradually over that period of 4 or 5 years, it developed into an adda for theatre, where everyone felt they could come, everyone knew they would meet each other, or from there they could establish contact with each other. And that is how that place became important.
How come the building was called Walchand Terrace? Was there a particular, it an older property?
It was a piece of property that had been purchased by Walchand Group for their offices. So when that building was built at Tar, it was really, the flats were leased out or not. was sold at a very nominal price to all their officers, and they had kept this one floor for their offices or need be whatever you require it. So for that reason, that was kept.
What was that space like? Was it like a big hall? Were there many rooms? What was that space like?
It was really like a big hall. It was like a place where you could compartment it for making offices. But it was when the offices were removed, there was, you know, it was like a big hall.
So it must have been...
With smaller rooms for cabins and also with facilities for toilet and a little kitchenette for making tea and things like that.
So it must have been what, about 2,000, 3,000 square feet? How large do you think it was?
I would imagine it was about 1,500 square feet.
Okay.
1,200 to 1,500 square feet.
Right.
It was really like a big hall, you know.
And so you mentioned that you went and saw Yayati.
I can't remember.
But do you remember where you saw this at that time? Do you remember from where you might it have seen it?
It would probably have been at Tejpal that we saw it. And we were quite surprised to see Jaswanti there. We had no idea that she had ambitions to act. You know, that is how she had become friendly with Satyadev.
Was it normal at that time for you to be going out and seeing a kind of a slightly off mainstream kind of play like Yayati, or a play that a theatre unit would be doing?
Well, you see, our family, the Walchand family particularly, my father-in-law and mother-in-law, were very deeply involved with Marathi theatre. But they were involved with the mainstream Marathi theatre. They were great admirers of P.L. Deshpande and these people. So I remember after I got married, I mean, I was a Gujarati, married to a Maharashtrian and taken to see Maharashtrian plays. And my first play that I saw with the family was Tuja Hai Tuja Bashi of P.L. Deshpande. And they used to go to all these plays at Kirewadi. And so theatre was in their blood. I mean, from whatever the family tells me, they all used to go to see Bal Gandharva. And my mother-in-law and all of emulated his styles and things like that. So this was there, and Vinod wanted to see this. Now, because I came from the arts field, I was also interested in experimental theatre, and I had read the play Look Back in Anger. So when and at that time we were mainly in Satara, so when we came to Bombay, if something was showing, we would go to see it. That's how it happened.
What kind of in the arts and performance area, what kind of space did, say, Dubey's theatre occupy? Was it seen as something quite avant-garde and something that, you know, one went to see because it was new? Did it occupy that kind of space?
In my mind, yes. And I think also in Vinod's mind. It was, you know, the connection with Vijaya. And Prafulla was also important in this, because she would tell us, "Are te hi bagna, Tendulkar ni far chan leela hai, hi bagna sarka hai." So that is how a little interest was developed, and we went to see it. Also Shashank's involvement, I don't know whether he did music for them or what he did. So that, Tumi Yana Bagaila, so that is how we got more and more involved.
So theatre was seen as something that, you know, occupied a kind of, it had a certain status at that time. Right, I mean, it was not seen as just purely like it is today to a large extent, a kind of a product for consumption. It was seen as an art form.
It depends on, I don't really know how others saw it. But I saw it as avant-garde art form, because I was interested in art and I was interested in avant-garde movements and all that. For Vinod, maybe because his love for theatre, it went, he sort of, earlier he may not have seen, but then he had been away 9 years and there wasn't that. So when this new movement is there, new things are being done, he got interested in it. And mine was purely academic. This is avant-garde, I have to know what it is.
What was Vinod's involvement in the theatre at that time when Dubey and others occupied Walchand Terrace? Did he get kind of involved in it even more than it before?
He was in, I think before Walchand Terrace, he kept telling Dubey, I want to act. Apparently, he did act in school plays. And he was very interested in theatre. So he told him, and I think that story, I forget which the name, somewhere, Chikatha.
Vallapuchi Danta Katha. Badal Sarkar.
He acted in it.
Yeah.
I think this was before Walchand Terrace was established. So he acted in it and he got involved in it. And then the involvement became more and more. And then when Walchand Terrace became free, I don't quite remember the sequence. But when it became free, then he offered it to Dubey. Okay, here is a place you can use. I mean, with no strings saying how long or anything, you can use it while we can spare it. So.
Did you ever get an opportunity to actually go to Walchand Terrace during this period?
Maybe once or twice, not very often.
Do you remember what you saw when you went there?
No, I went, it was again like a party we had there after the theatre, you know, or we went before and it was like an adda, you know, everything was spread out and people there and someone doing this, someone doing that. I would have gone only to meet Satyadev for something or meet Arvind if he was there for something. You see, what happened was also that, but this is before, this is after Walchand Terrace, because I think what happened was that Arvind, after my PhD thesis, Arvind asked me to do the costumes of Tughlaq, since I was working in the Sultanate period and all. So that is how maybe I had gone there. I can't remember which happened when.
Did Vinod go there on and off?
Must have, because you see, I was also writing my thesis and I went away for 4 months to Satara. So it's quite possible that in the evenings when he had nothing else to do, he would just go over and spend time there.
Did he ever talk about it, what was happening at Walchand Terrace?
No,
did you have?
No, he never really talked about it.
Did you at that time have an idea of, you know, the significance of what was going on there? Because, you know, much of this is in retrospect now, of course.
Yes,
but at that time?
Not at all. This, I would interpret it today that Vinod did it out of the generosity of his heart. He had no clue that he was doing something important. It was not done with that objective or that intention. He just did something. He said, here, I have something they can use. Let them use it while we can let them have it. And I think in 1971, or maybe it was 72, we asked, Shashank wanted that space for his studio, which is when Satyadev was asked to release it.
Yeah, it must have been 72, because I joined Dubey in 73 or so, and he had just lost that space. So he was actually, you know, looking around for something new at that time. So Vinod and none of you, did he ever express any regret about that space being given out to these people?
Not at all.
Yeah, he was positive about it to the
always
end?
Always very positive, always very helpful. I mean, I remember with Arvind's plays, nights spent by Vinod recording sounds for him, you know, on the spool. We had a little, he had a little office which served as an office and a music room and all that. Nights he has spent doing it. Initially, I would also be hanging around, but then it would go until 2 and 3 in the night, and that was not possible for me to hang around. And then it would be just Arvind and him and maybe one or two persons, hey, sound paijan, they sound paijan. So we were just, then became impediments. My was ready to be the hostess.
So in many ways, your own home seems to have been an extension of Walchand Terrace.
It was not even an extension, it was an annex. It was whatever, the activities just spilled on into our home. And there have been times, Sunil, when that and I would have gone out to dinner or something, and we came home and we saw six or seven people sleeping in the living room on the floor. You know, they had come to chat, and we weren't there. The house was always open.
Helped themselves to the bar
and chatted, and then went to sleep there. And Satyadev was once, because he rang the bell at night, no one opened the door, he slept on the landing. Can you beat that? So they felt totally at home.
Well, today it sounds like a very bohemian time.
It was a bohemian time. It was a very bohemian time. And I think our attitudes were also bohemian, and there's a hangover of it even today in our attitudes. But in our house, apart from play readings that were conducted, Vazir's play was conducted there. The first play he wrote, I can't remember the name of that play, but it was done in our living room. And Sai also did a play in our living room, where three sides of it, before Prithvi was built, it was like three sides that we had were used for people to sit and for the play to be enacted. And Jamshed Baba had specially come to see it.
Do you remember any of the productions that actually came out of Walchand Terrace at that time, either Arvind's or Dubey's? Do you remember anything specifically that, here we're doing a production, come and see it? Do you remember anything like that?
Well, Tughlaq, I remember, must have been done there, because that was soon after I did my PhD, which was 71. And I think Gidhade was
done there.
That was one of the major productions that was rehearsed there.
Gidhade was done there, and there was also this one was done there. With Bhakti and Deepa and
Adhyadure.
I think Adhyadure was also done there.
During Gidhade, there was a lot of controversy, with the censor board, and then it just got worse when Sakaram happened later on.
I think Sakaram also may have. Sakaram was not done by either.
No, it was done by Kamlakar.
Yes.
And then
Kamlakar also used to hang around.
Yeah. Not in Walchand Terrace.
No, maybe not in Walchand, but he used to be at our home quite often.
Yeah.
The two of them.
So when Gidhade ran into this kind of controversy, and there was a lot of attention, did you at that point, did you or Vinod, did people feel that now this is getting to be a bit on edge? Was the whole response to this kind of, this kind of censorship and, that kind
not
of pressure?
At all. We were in spirit and in thought together with the theatre people. We were very much with them. That this sort of thing shouldn't happen and all that. But it was all towards the end, of Walchand Terrace. And I personally also feel that was about the time that Shyam Benegal decided to do films. So, end of Walchand Terrace tenure, let's say, and Shyam Benegal wanting to do Ankur, all sort of dovetailed, and then most of the people that worked with Dubey went into the film, if you remember. I think Amrish was there, Rekha was there, many of these people then went into that.
So, was it like that? That theatre of a particular kind, and of course that was a period when this new wave cinema became very, very, popular and significant. Was it that kind of a composite culture at that time, where there was not so much kind of, division between theatre and cinema? It was all kind of, part of one.
I think it happened with Shyam and with Govind. Because Govind did helped Arvind with Shantata. And the film Shantata. And again, Vinod acted in that. Then in this Shyam's film, I think Shardata happened first.
Yes.
And thereafter, this so the connection with the New Wave film was just with these two. I don't remember any other people coming and doing it, you know.
Yeah.
And then Dubey also helped, and Girish and Dubey. We met Girish because of Dubey. We met Shyam because of Dubey. And we met various others, like Badal Sarkar, and there was some person called Paul or someone
Delhi. Yeah, yeah.
Yes, so all these people we met more, and more Vinod than I. Because Vinod would, you know, again, I was away a lot in those the period, because I was writing my thesis, then I went away abroad and things like that. I was traveling for my work. So I was not there all the time.
Yes,
and
yes.
Because I was not there, Vinod became more deeply involved with all these people. And after Walchand Terrace went, Satyadev moved into our house.
Yeah.
He stayed there for 3-4 years.
When did Vinod's involvement and interest start tapering off? Because after a particular point, it was not so direct as it used to be. Do you remember when and why that did happen?
I think the two or three things happened. One was that Walchand Terrace was gone. So that locus lost its focus. And all these people were not there. Then they all became involved in films. So they were not coming as much. Also, Vinod was having a trying time at Satara. There were problems of, there was a bit of a recession, not a bit of a recession, the machines were not moving, and he was facing a lot of trouble. So he was too preoccupied with those problems. In 72 and 73, that happened. So around that time, and then in 74, he moved to Walchandaka.
Mm-hmm.
And then his involvement, because Dubey was there through him, whatever was there, but he became far more involved in his own work. You know, that took most of his time rather than being able to devote time to theatre. And also the movement had sort of started dispersing. You know, Sunil, my sort of impression of this is like a lot of stars coming together at a certain period of time from different areas. And those 3 or 4 years were like when the constellation was formed. And then each one again went their different ways. See, it was just a period when they happened to be together. But each one was going in their different ways.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I think it kind of, you know, even more than ever underlines the role of a common space that becomes available. Because it's very hard for stars and constellations to form in limbo. You know, you need a home, you need a space where then they can come and rest and engage with each other. You know, and that's exactly what we are trying to kind of, you know, establish in this whole project.
But you see how important a part it played was not evident to us at that time. It was only when Girish dedicated a play to Walchand Terrace and he wrote to Vinod, saying, Vinod, I would have liked to have dedicated this play to you, but it would have been very embarrassing. So I have given it to the place you gave to us, which really was, which had a centrality,
sure,
which helped in giving us a certain thrust to the movement.
Yeah. You said that at that time things had started dissipating, you know, kind of certain fragmentation. Was it also, you know, if you look at that same period in a larger context, whether it's art or theatre or cinema, that after the 70s, we also moved historically into a phase where things kind of got scattered. You know, you see various progressive movements slowly breaking down. You know, the whole time changes. Do you think that is also a reflection of that?
To an extent, I would say. I would say even if Walchand Terrace would have been there, it may not have served the same sort of seminal role as it did when it did in the late 60s and early 70s. Actually, it was there, I think, from 69 to 71, 2 or 3 years only, not very much more. By 71 or 72, we had to take it back.
So 72.
Yeah, 72, we had to take it back. And we met Dubey in 67, so I think he must have given it to him in 68 or early 69. Oh. Yeah, so that's about 3 or 4 years.
Was the end of that space for theatre, was it a kind of a sad moment for everybody? Did everybody take to it easily?
I don't think people realized that it was ending. You know, there was so much enthusiasm with film then, with Shyam's film and Govind's film and all that. Maybe all of them felt they were just going to move into a different field altogether, and which they have, like Sulabha is now mostly in films. And so all these things, you know, I don't think people quite had a perspective on what was happening. In some ways, it was too exciting a period and too much was happening. Nobody knew where everyone was going. We were living very much in the present then.
I think Dubey did feel it, because I kind of joined him maybe a year and a half or so later, and it was though he was one never to be nostalgic about anything, he always wanted to look ahead, but you could sense that he was actually regrouping, you know. I think it was not just the space, but he'd also lost that core group. As you said, they had gone here, there, people had kind of, you know, disappeared and gone their own way. Some people he had thrown out, so it was not as though, you know, they didn't have a choice. But it's after that he starts forming a completely new group around him, and a much, much younger people now. You know, he had kind of taken a conscious decision that he would work with a lot more younger people. So I think deep down he must have felt a sense of loss, that somewhere his core had been sort of shifted from, you know, that kind of thing. Though
I didn't quite get that feeling. You see, as I said, around 73, when he was staying with us, he had decided to take up a job with Lintas. And he had also decided to give up his column in the papers. And when he decided to take a job with Lintas, my son, who was only 10 years old at that time, 11 years old, was shattered. You know, for him, Dubey was an idol, and it turned out to be an idol with feet of clay. He says, you are taking a Lintas job, you know, with your communistic thinking and all. I mean, he was only 10. He didn't know what communistic thinking and all that was. But he was so upset that Satyadev was not going to do what he was going to do, he had been doing, but was going to take up a job. I think he took up a job, and then it really did not, I don't know what happened, he did not. Then in between, he decided to work with Mahesh Bhatt. I can't remember the sequence. And then for a while he was hanging around after he'd sort of moved away from us, maybe out of resentment that space was not there for him anymore. Then he went to Ajit and Meera's, and he was there, staying there for a while. So he was also in a state of flux. I mean, in going through some instability in his own mind as to what he wanted to do, where he wanted to go. And things like that.
Sure. No, I don't say that he resented it. It was just that it had become such a from all accounts that we hear from different people, it had become such a comfortable space, and they had started taking it so much for granted that when one day it wasn't there, everybody had to suddenly, you know, find their own feet and look for something else. That way, I don't remember him ever sort of saying that, oh, I lost it, and that it was just one of those realities that he wanted to deal with.
He often told us.
Oh, he made it sure. Yeah.
When he was staying with us, he would, yes, now that I have no space, you know, it had almost become like it was his space, and we had taken it. But which is natural, and as you said, such a comfort zone. And also he must have himself felt that fire of creativity, which certainly seemed to have dimmed a little, because you felt because he was planning to take up this job, because then he was moving from here to there, and very obviously wanting to show I'm shifting my loyalties and things like that, you know. He was being childish about it.
Yeah.
But that was Dubey, you know.
That was him.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, that was also charming about him.
No, that's why I don't think it was a particular instable period. It was just that Walchand Terrace gave him stability and then he went back to his normal state. That's basically what happened.
Possibly.
You know? Yeah.
Possibly. Yeah. And then that... But he always counted us among his close friends.
Of course, of course.
And on his birthdays, he would invite five or six of us women to lunch. It was Neera and me and I can't remember who the others were, but Neera was there, I was there. Maybe Sulabha was there. So we were always invited for lunch.
Of course, of course.
And then he used to sit at the coffee shop at the Taj all night to write his plays. This is like he started, you know, grouping for places.
Well, that's exactly what we're trying to establish, that it's so important for, I mean, you know, Chabildas created a space for a particular kind of theatre for almost 8 to 10 years and it flourished. You know, Prithvi came up, it's flourished as a theatre space. So a particular kind of theatre needs a home, and when there is a home, it's happened in Bangalore. Rang Shankara came up, immediately there was a blossoming of activity, you know. So spaces are so important where, you know, for something like this to happen. Yeah.
But then why isn't Sangeet Natak Academy or anyone helping in this?
No. You see, that's the problem. The state will never recognize this. They will never. Why are you talking about Sangeet? What about the National Center for the Performing Arts? They have the space. But it does not have the warmth that, you know, theatre needs. You know, that's everything is calculated out there. When Walchand Terrace came into existence, there was no calculation there. It was a space, it was offered. Or when Chabildas came, there was no calculation there. That's the difference. That's the difference. It's how you actually see the space, you see the value of it, you know.
But I think if this was pointed out, maybe Chavan Centre can do something. But there's just so many centres coming up.
Yeah,
you know, actually there is a center coming up. Bombay Art Society is has built a building opposite the Leelavati, and they have done a little theater, maybe of only 100 people. And I said, I wish you'd done it for about 150 or 200. Then I would have helped in the cost and called it Vinod Doshi Theatre or something.
Mm.
But they said it's only for lectures. But even today, people are getting interested in lectures. 100, 200 people come at
easily.
The drop
easily.
Of a hat.
Easily.
And here, you see, it becomes very interesting because then it caters to this area.
Sure.
You know,
sure.
Rather than there.
Yeah.
But, you know, I could not convince Prafulla, who was in charge. I mean, I blame myself because she asked me to be in charge. But I didn't want to get involved in that thing. So I didn't, and I didn't look into the plans. At least could have helped her with that.
Yeah.
And it was like she had decided that before I retire, this is one job I want to complete. So she has done that.
Fair enough.
Which will be quite a central place. I mean, near the Leelavati is a good place for people from Bandra, Dadar, anyone.
Absolutely. And because of the sea link, now that's a very comfortable place. Comfortable. Just get off the sea link and you're there. You know, so even South Bombay opens up.
People from South Bombay come. Even if they don't come, you have such a wide...
Big hinterland here. Yeah.
So that will happen.
Okay, so this is basically...
Mainly this.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much.
Not at all.
Thank
but
you.
I do want you to also include the fact, I don't have to say it, that the film party was based on all those parties.
Those parties, so yes, of course.
Yeah, because it was something I didn't know till Vijay pointed it out.
True.
So that...
No, we knew that the film party was based on theatre parties. We knew that, obviously. It was quite clear for the kind of characters.
I haven't seen it, you know. It was done when I was away. She told me that they came to ask for my saris, but since I wasn't there, I couldn't give them to them. And then Prafulla gave her saris.
Okay.
It was truly based on all that.
Well, if you see it, you'll realize this Govind's idea of the parties in your house. I don't think it's a completely true reflection. It's his idea of the parties in your house.
Yeah, possibly.
I'm sure you wouldn't have liked to have such parties in your house.
There have been parties where there have been big quarrels, you know.
No, it's not just the quarrels. It's a bit notional. But anyway, it's an interesting film because you see a lot of familiar faces. He managed to put together a cast of, it's really an ensemble thing. So some of it is very interesting purely from a historical point of view. At that point of time, who are the people who are involved in cinema and theatre? They're all there in that film. So it's very interesting.
Do you know Kumud Ben was introduced by me to them?
Oh, huh. Okay.
You see, she was an English, she'd done her graduation in English, or maybe post-graduation. And she was used to be in the museum library editing their journal. And I used to go there for my PhD. So we would meet there every day, and then over a period of time we got to know each other and became friends. And then because she was an English major, I once invited her saying that there is this reading, or these people are coming to my house, why don't you and Arvindai come? So both of them came, and in that Kumud Ben and Vijay Tendulkar became friends. And then of course everyone became friends with her because she was always very happy to look up references and things like that. But particularly Vijay Tendulkar, because she has often come with me. She would ring me up, are you going to the museum? Then I'll come with you. I have to look up this for Vijay Tendulkar. Oh. I have to find this reference for him. So she had, you would, earlier her communistic background, she would not want to come. Yeah. Then it was so interesting to see the change in her also, you know. She would say, I would leave around lunchtime every day. She was supposed to work until 5. Then she would say, no, it's very hot here. I'll come with you in your air-conditioned car. And then I would say, chala atta, ghari alata, come and have lunch with me. And she knew Bai and all because, you know, her in-laws, my mother-in-law had known.
Okay.
So she came there and she would then Bai and she would chat about it and chat about something in theatre also and this and that. She knew much more of Marathi, old Marathi theatre, yes, than I did. So she would, then it became like a habit every now and again, I mean very fairly frequently, she would come back with me and have lunch with her at our house. And she was just a stone
across the road, very close by. Yeah.
So that is how Kumud Ben got into this thing.
I see. And then of course, she went on to her thing at the NCPA,
yes,
and then the journal.
Yes, but she got the NCPA job because of that.
Right, exactly. Yeah, that must have been the connection.
Connection was that someone, Baba must have asked somebody and they must have said she is there and she can help her. I think PL was there, no?
No, she was there prior to PL. Narayan Menon.
Narayan Menon.
She was there from Narayan Menon time.
She was chosen by Baba, I know.
Possibly, because at that time he was very active in setting up the NCPA.
But Vinod was put by Jamshed Baba on experimental theatre committee.
I see.
He had, knowing Vinod's interest, and as I said, he had come to see the play that Sai had done in my house and all that. So he knew of Vinod's interest and he put Vinod on it, but Vinod felt that he really didn't take, the committee was not active to do things. And you know how little things happen. For example, Ranade had once set up a workshop on theatre designing of costumes. Anyway, he asked me to talk on designing of costumes. So I took with me slides, you know, of how I had planned the Tughlaq costumes, what were the thoughts that went behind it, what was the way in which we designed them, and how much was the budget, and how we included all this in, because we went and bought from those Haryana stalls. You remember at one time they would be on the streets. So those chadars we bought, very cheap ones, and we made those costumes. And shoes, those boots and those sort of cuffs and all that. And then I told them that when the play opened, there was criticism that this looks like costumes from the Crusades.
I see.
Yeah, there was a person called Natkarni.
Yeah, Gnaneshwar Natkarni.
Not Gnaneshwar.
Oh.
It was another Natkarni.
Kamlakar.
Because Gnaneshwar I knew quite well. And he said that these look like the Crusades and not this. So then I replied to him in the papers that this was the research done behind it and this is the way in which the costumes were arrived at. So then he says, what difference does it make? After all, it is all notional. Then what was the point in criticizing it in the first place? So I was going to write that. So Girish says, now Saryu, stop getting involved in it. Just ignore it. And so I told these people all that. And that was the end of that episode. And a few years later, the NCPA or something, I run into a young man. He comes up to me and says, are you Dr. Doshi? You remember you gave that talk? He says, I still remember it as it was one of the most interestingly sort of conveyed, you know, how things are done and all that in costumes. Otherwise, who would think designing costumes is interesting? So somewhere, you know, being with the theatre people and you discuss things and you realize what they want and how it should be done. That helped me design that talk.
Absolutely, yeah. And I guess at that time, not that much work went into costume design as,
no.
You know, it was still a very new area, especially in this kind of theatre. It was not such a,
No, the thing was everyone was influenced by Vijaya, who was influenced by Czech plays or something. All those dark robes they wore, you know, this one kept telling me, Arvindu Vaslik colors given nako sari, but I was looking at tonal values, you know, on a stage, how you would have this tone with this tone and that, and not just dark browns and things like that. So Vijaya had, after her chalk circle, had influenced people tremendously into costumes. So, actually, even in your stories in a song, you know, where those three Greek figures reminded me of those chalk circle costumes.
So
there were influences from various sides, talks from various people. Then Tendulkar would often come, sit there, and others, who was Vasant Kanetkar also. Then through Arvind we met Kanti Madhya, so we went to Gujarati plays as well. And he did all this mainstream theatre with Vasant Kanetkar's things and all. And became very close friends. So we got introduced to all this, I mean through Dubey, through Arvind, through Kanti, through this one, through that one.
Yeah, you were also situated geographically in a space which was surrounded a lot by many little performance spaces. Tejpal, Sahitya Sangh Mandir, you know, then you had Walchand Terrace across here, Sofia Bhabha here. So, a whole lot of theatre spaces. Yeah.
At that time, they also performed at that Bhulabahi space. You remember at Kolaba? Near, you know, that LIC building.
Yeah. Bhulabahi Hall,
Was a Bhulabahi
Desai Hall. Bhulabahi Desai Hall was there.
Bhulabahi
Auditorium was there.
Which has been pulled down. Huh?
Yeah, got pulled down. There was Patkar was there. That is hardly used anymore. Mm. Yeah, there were a lot of performance spaces. Bhavans has been there for the longest time. Still there. Still works, functions. Yeah.
But you see, it's all become like classified. For example, Bhavans is Gujarati. Tejpal is has a mixed audience.
Gujarati.
Mainly Gujarati. But he was very helpful to Satyadev.
Yes, at that time.
Yeah.
IPTA and theatre unit did a lot of work there.
But you know, at that time, I remember that Satyadev would say, you know, my auditorium is going to be empty, Vinod and Saryu would do something. So we would invite people for the play, after the play to come and meet the cast for cocktails and they invariably stayed for dinner. Then the dinner would often be just scrambled eggs or something. Because 50 people, how have I to provide dinner for? And there were initially, when we first got to know Satyadev and all, Amol and Chitra and Rekha and Deepa and all these people would come on Sundays to our house. It would be from about 11:30 till 8 at night. You know, they were there discussing, arguing, and there had been a time when Satyadev got very drunk and he and Vinod got into a fight. He said something to me which I didn't mind, but Vinod didn't like it. So he said, "You're not going to talk like that to my wife." So he said, "What do you mean? She's also my friend," or something. And then such a big quarrel happened that Satyadev walked out. And we had to send people to get him. But that was the first break between Vinod and Satyadev's friendship. I mean, after that, it was never the same.
Same as before. Yeah.
And I took it in jest. Neither he nor Vinod took it in jest. Then he stayed at Shyam's house for some time. Then he would come back to our house, but then go to Ajit's house. You know, and very often it was like, "Don't think I need you," that attitude, you know. So there were many things that happened, you know. It was a nice time of our lives, involved in a sort of bohemian atmosphere. And for Vinod it was very important, because he was otherwise in a very stultifying corporate atmosphere. And then finally he also became that. It was just so overpowering that finally you had to conform.